Hi, I'm Attorney Ben Schwartz. Today I'm going to answer a question from Alan in Dover, Delaware. Alan posed this question. He says, I'm currently in a paralegal program and would like to know if any of your paralegals do anything with quadratic equations. 97% of us are scratching our heads on if we would ever use this in our field. It's a college degree requirement, but as an infantryman and former police officer, we focused on what we will most likely deal with in the real world. So, Alan wants to know, as part of my college degree program, gonna get a degree as a paralegal, should I have to learn about quadratic equations? Now, a lot of you are watching this saying, what in the heck is a quadratic equation? It's a type of math equation that you need to learn if you want to essentially plot something on a graph with four quadrants. Alan, I think that the question is, the direct answer is, it depends on what type of paralegal are you going to be. If you're going to be a paralegal assisting criminal defense attorneys who are handling murder cases, you might want to know something about quadratic equations, because if you have to chart the trajectory of a bullet, you need to be able to know and understand quadratic equations, because the path a bullet follows is a quadratic equation. It's a parabola. The better answer is you may never need to know quadratic equations. Quite frankly, I learned quadratic equations when I was in college and forgot all about them. And your question, you know, brought back some memories of my college days, but I haven't used quadratic equations in 20 years, and I don't think I'll ever need to use them, because I'm never going to be likely to chart the trajectory of bullets or anything else that would need me to employ my knowledge of quadratic equations. The better answer to this question, I think, is that as you go through college, as you go through the university, or as you go through life, as you go through your job, you need to stop resisting the way things are. In other words, as you go through life, as you go through education, or as you go through any system, there is the way that things are done, the way that things proceed. And sometimes it really pays to fight back against that way. But most of the time, it really pays if you sort of lose yourself and you don't resist, and you go ahead and follow along. So in your degree program, they mandate that you take certain math classes, advanced math classes, and they mandate that you learn quadratic equations. And if you want to get the degree, you take the class, you buckle under, and you learn what you need to learn, and you take the exams you need to take, and you do well on them, and you move on, and you can forget about it later because you probably are not going to use it. And if you are going to use it, you can go back and relearn it from a book or relearn it from your notes. But I think that there is a way that the world is going to proceed, and if you try and fight against it, you're beating your head against the wall. But if you learn to go with the flow, then you're really doing yourself a favor, and you'll really get a lot further. It reminds me of when I was a kid. I grew up at South Bowers Beach, Delaware. And what separates South Bowers Beach from North Bowers Beach is a river called the Murderkill River. And I used to like to go fishing up the river for perch. Had the biggest perch up the river, but you had to get pretty far up the river. And so I liked to go fishing when I wanted to go fishing, which meant that I had a small boat. I had a 7.5 horsepower air-cooled Briggs & Stratton motor on the back of that boat. And if I wanted to go fishing at 10 o'clock in the morning, I would go fishing at 10 o'clock in the morning. The problem is that if the tide was coming out of the river when I wanted to go up the river, I was fighting against an eight-knot current, because it was a quick-moving river. And so I found that instead of fighting against the tide, if I waited until the tide started coming in and went up the river, and then I fished until the tide turned and started going out, then I could come back out the river. My engine would never overheat. I would get as far as the good fishing grounds, and I would always eat well. So my advice to you, Alan, is figure out what is the way, follow the way. Don't fight against it. Go with the flow, and you'll find that you get your degree and that you become successful, and things are much easier for you when you follow along rather than when you try to buck against the system. I'm attorney Ben Schwartz. Hope you found this video informative and interesting. If you have a question for me, legal, philosophical, or otherwise, send me an email, ben.schwartz@schwartzandschwartz.com, or go on our Facebook page, facebook.com/schwartzandschwartz, and leave us a comment or message us there.